Madam President, the eyes of the world have been on Washington all this week, and that is a gross understatement. And while they witnessed a great deal of political discord, today they will also see Congress reach a historic bipartisan agreement to reopen the government and avert a default on the nation's bills. The compromise we reached will provide our economy with the stability it desperately needs. It's never easy for two sides to reach consensus. It's really hard, sometimes harder than others. This time was really hard. But after weeks spent facing off across a partisan divide that often seemed too wide to cross, our country came to the brink of a disaster. But in the end, political adversaries set aside their differences and disagreements to prevent that disaster. I thank the Republican leader for his diligent efforts to reach this important agreement. The Republican leader's cooperation was essential to reach an accord that could pass both chambers of Congress and also be signed by President Obama. As part of our agreement, and in order to assure Congress continues the work of setting this country on a path of fiscal sustainability, this legislation instructs leaders to name conferees to a budget conference committee that will set our country on a long-term path to fiscal sustainability. Madam President, I know that some say it's going to be hard, but what we do is hard here, and this is really hard, but I think we can get it done. The committee members selected must have open minds, be willing to consider every option, no matter how painful to their own political ideas and even their own political parties. This conference committee, led by Chairman Murray and Chairman Ryan, which will produce its negotiated budget resolution in December, is the appropriate place to discuss our different views of the best way to chart a course for economic growth. This legislation also funds the government through January 15th and averts default through February 7th, during which time we can work toward a long-term budget agreement that prevents these frequent crises. And perhaps most importantly, this legislation ends a standoff, the groundwork of Washington to a halt this fall. Madam President, this is not a time for pointing fingers of blame. This is a time of reconciliation. I look forward to working with my colleagues on both sides of this great capital to pass this remarkable agreement, which will protect the long-term health of our economy and avert a default on our nation's debt and allow us to set a foundation for economic expansion. What we've done is sent a message to Americans from every one of our 50 states, but in addition to that, to the citizens of every country in the world, that the United States lives up to its obligations. Now Congress must return to its most important job, fostering economic growth and protecting middle-class families. I appreciate through all this the steady hand of President Obama, who helped guide us to this conclusion. I'm optimistic that the spirit of compromise that has taken root in the Senate over the last 2 days will endure. I do know this. Senator McConnell and I have sat in very, very serious discussions the last 2 days. We're going to do everything we can to change the atmosphere in the Senate and accomplish things that need to be done for our country.
Madam President.
The Republican leader.
This has been a long, challenging few weeks for Congress and for the country. It's my hope that today we can put some of those most urgent issues behind us. After yesterday's events, the Majority Leader and I began a series of conversations about a way to get the government reopened and to prevent default. I'm confident we'll be able to do both those things later today. Crucially, I'm also confident that we'll be able to announce that we're protecting the government spending reductions that both parties agreed to under the Budget Control Act, and that the President signed into law. That's been a top priority for me and for my colleagues on the Republican side of the aisle throughout this debate, and it's been worth the effort. Some have suggested that we break that promise as part of this agreement. Some have said Washington needs to spend more, that we need to raise taxes, that we need to just tax our way to prosperity and balance. But what the BCA showed is that Washington actually can cut spending. And because of this law, that's just what we've done. For the first time since the Korean War, For the first time since the Korean War, government spending has declined for 2 years in a row, the first time in 50 years. And we're not going back on this agreement. There's a lot more we need to do to get our nation's fiscal house in order. Hopefully, once we've gotten past the drama of the moment, we can get to work on it. But for now, let's not understate the importance of the Budget Control Act or the importance of the fight to preserve it. This legislation is the largest spending reduction bill of the last quarter century and the largest deficit reduction bill since 1981 that didn't include a tax hike. Preserving this law is critically important to the future of our country. Throughout this debate, the public has rightly focused on Obamacare, for good reason. This law is ravaging our economy, killing jobs, driving up premiums, and driving people off the health care plans they have and like in droves. Its disastrous rollout is a sign of even worse things to come. And the refusal to delay it reflects a kind of stubborn ideological obsession that will do untold damage to our country. And Republicans remain determined to repeal this terrible law. But for today, the relief we hope for is to reopen the government, avoid default, and protect the historic cuts we achieved under the Budget Control Act. This is far less than many of us had hoped for, frankly, but it's far better than what some had sought. Now it's time for Republicans to unite behind other crucial goals. Madam President, I yield the floor.